How much pesticide should you buy? Once you know the area of the field you want to cover and the pesticide rate, a simple calculation will tell you exactly how much pesticide you will have to buy. Here's how it's done. Area to be covered times the pesticide rate equals the amount of pesticide needed. If the area to be covered is 30 hectares and the pesticide rate is 4.4 liters per hectare, you will need to buy 132 liters of pesticide. That's 30 hectares multiplied by 4.4 liters, which equals 132 liters of pesticide. In real terms, these calculations tell you that you need to buy 14 10-liter jugs of post to deal with the quackgrass problem in this field. Remember, if you use acres, make sure the pesticide rate is correct by multiplying the label rate by 0.4. In the previous example, 4.4 liters per hectare would convert to 1.76 liters per acre. To get some practice in doing these calculations, stop the tape and do problems 1 and 2 in the section of your workbook with the title, How Much Pesticide Should You Buy? Don't forget to check your answers. How much area will one spray tank cover? As a rough gauge of whether you're putting too much or not enough on, it's also handy to know how much of your field one spray tank will cover. The method of calculating this is the same whether you use liters or gallons, acres or hectares. Simply divide the tank size by the calibrated sprayer output. Before you do problem number 3, remember that the tank size and the sprayer output have to be measured in the same units, either both in gallons or both in liters. A spray tank holds 1,000 liters and its calibrated output is 250 liters per hectare. How many hectares will be covered by one full tank? The tank size is 1,000 liters divided by calibrated sprayer output, 250 liters per hectare, which equals 4 hectares. Therefore, one full tank will cover 4 hectares. Calibrating your sprayer will tell you exactly what the sprayer output is, and you need to know that to find out the area covered by one tank. If you don't calibrate your sprayer and you guess at the output, you might be putting on too much or too little.
Calibration doesn't just do one thing for you, it does a number of different things for you. But it's crucial because based on the sprayer output, that's what you use to then mix up your chemicals in that tank. If you haven't calibrated, you're using your best guess or your best estimate from years past, and you may be real close, but you also may be quite a ways away from the actual sprayer output. In that case, you may get you may be under-applying herbicides or pesticides, or you may be over-applying. In other words, you may get weed control or you may not. You may get more than weed control.
Now, stop the tape and do problems 4 and 5 in the section of your workbook entitled, How Much Area Will One Spray Tank Cover? There are all sorts of safety and other considerations when it comes to mixing and loading, but right now we are going to show you how to calculate how much pesticide to add to a full tank. To figure out how much, multiply the area covered by one tank by the pesticide rate for the pesticide you are using. That will tell you the amount of pesticide needed for one full tank. Let's work through an example. A farmer has 18 hectares of apples. He wants to use Captan 50% wettable powder fungicide to control apple scab. The label rate is 2 kilograms per hectare. His sprayer holds 1,000 liters and has a calibrated output of 250 liters per hectare. How much Captan fungicide should he add to each tank? The first step is to calculate the area covered by one tank. You've already learned how to do this calculation. The tank size is 1,000 liters, divided by the calibrated sprayer output, which is 250 liters per hectare, which equals 4 hectares. That's how much area one tank will cover. The second step is to calculate the amount of pesticide to add to each tank. To do that, we multiply the area covered by one tank by the pesticide rate. In this case, 4 hectares times 2 kilograms per hectare, which equals 8 kilograms. Therefore, the farmer needs to add 8 kilograms of Captan fungicide to each tank of solution. Remember, because this is a metric question, the pesticide rate is the very same as the label rate. If we were dealing with acres, we would have to use the converted label rate. Stop the tape and review the example given on the worksheet entitled How Much Pesticide to Add to a Full Tank, and check your answers. How much area in your field is left to spray? After applying one or more full tanks of pesticide, there's often an area left to spray that does not require a full tank. You must then decide how much area is left to spray. The first step is to subtract the area covered with full tanks from the total area to be covered. That will tell you how much area still needs to be sprayed. You will need a part tank of spray mix to finish spraying the area. Let's take a look at an example. A farmer has 27 acres to spray. His sprayer volume is 300 gallons and its output is 30 gallons per acre. He has calculated that one full tank will spray 10 acres. The pesticide he is using has a label rate of 1.1 liters per hectare. Our farmer has already figured out that one full tank will spray 10 acres, and he has already sprayed 20 acres of his 27-acre field using 2 full tanks. By subtracting the area treated, 20 acres, from the total area he needs to cover, 27 acres, he finds out he has 7 acres left to spray. How much pesticide is needed for only part of a tank? Now that he knows how many acres he has left to spray, this farmer can figure out how much pesticide is needed for only part of a tank. Here's how it's done. Multiply the area left to spray by the pesticide label rate, which will equal the amount of pesticide needed for only part of a tank. The pesticide label rate for the pesticide he is using is 1.1 liters per hectare, which he multiplies by 0.4 to get the converted label rate in acres, which comes to 0.44 liters per acre. By multiplying the area left to spray, in this case 7 acres, by the converted label rate, 0.44 liters per acre, he is able to determine that he needs 3.08 liters of pesticide to finish spraying the field. Before you go to the next section, stop the tape and review the calculations in this example as outlined in the worksheets in your workbook entitled How Much Area in Your Field is Left to Spray and How Much Pesticide is Needed for Only Part of a Tank. How much spray mix is needed for only part of a tank? Not only is it important to know how much pesticide is needed for only part of a tank, it is also important to know how much water is required. The worksheet entitled How Much Spray Mix is Needed for Only Part of a Tank shows you how to calculate this. The term spray mix refers to the mixture you actually spray on the field, which is made up of both water and pesticide. To figure out how much spray mix is needed for only part of a tank, multiply the area left to spray by the calibrated sprayer output. This calculation will tell you the amount of spray mix needed for only part of a tank. For example, a farmer has a 35-acre field. His tank size is 300 gallons and its output is 30 gallons per acre. He has calculated that one full tank will spray 10 acres. The label rate for the pesticide he is using is 1.4 liters per hectare. After spraying 3 full tanks, he knows he doesn't need a full tank to complete the job, but he is not sure just how much spray mix is required to finish off the field. The first step is to figure out how much area is left to spray. In this case, 35 acres, the total area of the field, minus the area already sprayed, 30 acres, equals 5 acres left to spray. Having calibrated his sprayer, the farmer knows the sprayer output is 30 gallons per acre. Therefore, he has all the information he needs to figure out how much spray mix is needed to finish the job. Stop the tape now and review the formula given on the worksheet entitled How Much Spray Mix is Needed for Only Part of a Tank. And then complete step 3 of this example. Check your answer and then do problem number 6. The mathematics involved in spraying is really not all that difficult. Knowing how to do these calculations properly can benefit you and the environment. When answering any calculation question, you really only need to know 4 pieces of information. 1, the area to be sprayed. 2, the pesticide rate. 3, the tank size. 4, the calibrated sprayer output. At the end of section 1 of your workbook, there are more sample problems. Get this information out of the word problems first, and it will be easier for you to answer the questions. Use the tear-out sheets at the back of section 1 to help you remember how to do the calculations. Keep these sheets in a safe place. They will come in handy at spraying time next year. Doing the sample problems will give you practice in applying what you have learned so far, and it will help prepare you for the Grower Pesticide Certification Course exam. Remember, none of this information will be of any use to you unless you calibrate your sprayer. If you don't know how, the Ministry of Agriculture and Food does offer help. Contact your local office.